We have listened to the lecture, we have listened to the panel, and we have listened to the discussions. And I must say, I really don't know what I can say at this stage. However, allow me first to sincerely express my gratitude for being invited to make closing remark at this very important lecture organized jointly by SADC, Uongozi, and the University of Dar es Salaam, and to thank them all for inviting me and for organizing this timely public lecture. I'm saying it's a timely public lecture because deepening integration in SADC is what we all need, as that is the only process that will lead us to the full integration of the region and the continent. Thus, to enable us to address the challenges facing our people, which were clearly articulated here, underdevelopment and poverty. 2 years ago, I had a chance to accompany my president on a state visit to China. And when we were traveling to different places, we were meeting different people. And they were all behaving more or less the same. They were talking the same. And I said to them, what makes you to be just repeating, behaving all the time the same? And then they say, you know what is guiding us? First, we believe on the proverbs of our ancestors. And second, we believe or we are being inspired by the founders of our country. And that is what puts us together. When that response was given to me, then I recall sometimes back, maybe 15 years or 16 years ago, I was one of those who were identified as Africa eminent persons to go and make an assessment on the operations of the Organization of African Unity, both its agencies as well as its secretariat and all the organs. For 3 months, we were in Addis Ababa trying to understand, and what we concluded, we were 11 of us, is that unlike our forefathers who had the founders or the founders of the Organization of African Unity, the current setup, we don't have a common clear denominator. And exactly we have put that in our report, and that is what President Mkapa is telling us today. That the Nkrumahs, the Nyereres, had one common goal, and that is the total liberation of the African continent. Today we were supposed to have a common goal of the total economic independence of the continent. Unfortunately, from the findings we did at that time, we are still in the process to identify that common denominator that can bring us together and make us to speak the same thing with one voice and to act the same at all times. And I must say, SADC as an organization is also part and parcel of the African continent. I agree that SADC region, we are privileged that our developmental agenda is built on a strong foundation and anchored in a principle which stem from the vision of our founders who were foresighted in their resolve for a better region and continent. Also, as already said by President Mkapa, our region has experienced a protracted liberation struggle during which we did not only share food and shelter, but died together, thus giving us a permanent oneness and this supposed to make it easy for us to identify our common denominator as we stand here today. We all know that at the forefront of inculcating the spirit of integration, socio-economic cohesion was eminent teacher Mwalimu Julius Kambarage Nyerere. SADC, we all know, has its roots from the Bush Conference, the frontline states, and the Southern Africa Development Coordination Conference. It was already mentioned here. And of course, Mwalimu has played a central role in the regional formation, looking on how best we can work together to address the challenges facing our people. And all liberation movements in Southern Africa have operated from Tanzania, a country that has even accepted to host the AU Liberation Coordinating Committee. I'm saying all this because unless we recognize where we are coming from, who did what, we'll not be able to move forward with confidence. It's therefore not wrong to say that our connectedness as a region and our continued pursuit for a more deepened integration were born in this country. And thank once again for the revolutionary leadership of Mwalimu, a true Pan-Africanist who declared that Tanzania could not be independent if the whole continent is not liberated. In itself for me is telling us that regional and continental integration is a must. And we owe it to Mwalimu and his pair to ensure that what they stood for is realized. Namibia very much values regional integration as it's important in the expansion of the market, a factor in the area of economic growth and sustainable development. And this explains why Namibia is giving land free of charge to all our landlocked neighbors to develop dry ports, thus making it possible for them to become land-linked countries. We are doing this because in our agenda of integration, where we talk about trade and investment, we are looking at the whole Africa as a continent. And the port of Walvis Bay is very strategic for trade between the Southern Africa, the Central and West Africa. And that's why 2 weeks ago, we had to open the container terminal in Walvis Bay in order to enable us to move our goods for trade purpose. At the same time, we are engaging with our neighbors to make sure that all of them are connected by rail to the harbor, because currently all of them are connected by Tyre Road. Your Excellency, I would like to agree with the sentiments that SADC is well positioned to share its key lessons with the rest of the continent, because surely, since the establishment of SADC, much has been achieved. And I agree, in the area of peace, we are a leading region. And peace is a prerequisite for development. If you do not have peace, you cannot talk about development. So therefore, we have to be proud of that, because it's leading us to achieve the SADC that we want. In the same vein, we have a responsibility to ensure that we have to be more realistic when we take stock of what we have done and what we have not done. And I must thank the panelists who have been very open, especially to us who are in government. But time has come for us to tell each other the reality if we are to address the challenges our people are facing. Our current president, when he took over as a president of the Republic of Namibia, I'm now referring to Dr. Hage Geingob, he clearly said we have poverty in Namibia. And for that reason, say we have to declare war against the poverty. Because if we do not accept where we are weak, we will not be able to address those weaknesses. I'm sure many of our people, especially the drivers, they feel a sense of belongingness when they look at their driving license, which are written SADC. That's an achievement. But the question is, in order to enable the general public to feel the process of integration, they are asking the question, when will they have a similar identity or even a passport that can allow them to study and even do business in the region on equal terms? I singled out education and business because we are talking about the need of the necessary skill. The issue here now is for us, we are preparing ourselves to make sure that we implement all the protocols that we have signed, which are aimed particularly to look at the issue of the free movement of people. Your Excellencies, I fully agree, SADC has made good progress. For example, there are areas where we can really be proud. I want to mention the issue of energy, where we talk about the Southern Africa power pool. This has translated into a great direct benefit for our people through power sharing arrangements, which are able to balance energy surplus and deficit in the region. However, I agree, in the other hand, there are sometimes a tendency that national interest and sovereignty becomes impediment to our ability to move the regional initiative project ahead. For example, the issue of value chain has been on the card for some time. It was already mentioned here, the importance of value chain, as that's the only way we'll be able to have a balanced development rather than having product concentrating in one country where they are produced and the others become the receivers. And then jobs are created in one. And that's why SADC has developed an industrialized strategy in order to address those issues. Now we have identified potential value chains in the region which have a specific focus on combination of how our individual and regional strategies can be leveraged for optimal benefit from both regional and global value chain. This approach specifically allows us to profile the sectors in each country and develop the strategies for value addition, beneficiation, and downstream processing. It also allows us to have a vested interest in promoting investment in the regional project, as we are able to reap collectively benefit for all people in our region. Your Excellency, the third summit of SADC heads of state and government was held under the theme Infrastructure Development for Youth Empowerment for Sustainable Development. And it was at this summit where Namibia became a chair of the SADC and I became the chair of the Council of Ministers. We agree on this theme because we believe that as we forge ahead with our development agenda and regional integration, our youth must be on the forefront. It's very unfortunate when we see African young people risking their lives, trying to cross the oceans with the hope of a better life. In fact, me, I call it, they are following their jobs that we have transported to other continents when we are sending unprocessed raw material. We are exporting jobs. In fact, Africa is a net job exporter. And that is what SADC would want to bring to an end. And that is why the theme that focuses on the youth empowerment and infrastructure development in order to enable us to develop the necessary skill. On my arrival in Dar es Salaam this time around, I was highly impressed by the pace at which infrastructure development is taking place. And this speaks to our goal of regional connectivities and enhancing our collaborative ability to facilitate the free movement of goods and services as foreseen in the SADC Free Trade Area. Again, this is one of the areas in which our region can contribute and benefit to the implementation of the Africa Continental Free Trade Area once it becomes operationalized. SADC has also made good progress in the area of women empowerment. I know my executive secretary was ready to give a response or a reaction because this issue was raised. We have made good progress in the area of women empowerment. Particularly, we have agreed that it should be a standing agenda item in our agenda so that every year we have to receive progress. Where we stand now, women are playing a major role both in the political and economic field in our region. If we look at women representation in the SADC region in parliament, they are the highest in comparison to other regions. In Namibia, for example, we stand at 47% in our National Assembly. And this has also become possible. It has also become possible when SWAPO, the ruling party, has taken a decision and put it in a constitution that the Secretary General of the party is here. We put it in the constitution to have 50-50 women representation in all party structures. And because our National Assembly election is proportional representation, when we send our list, it's a zebra list. If the first is a woman, the second is a man, and it goes like that. Again, because of that, our top four, which is the president, the vice president, the secretary general, and the deputy secretary general are 50-50. For example, our current president of the Republic of Namibia, Dr. Hage Geingob, is also the president of the party. Then the vice president of the party is the one talking to you. Netumbo Nandi-Ndaitwah. And then the secretary general is a woman. The deputy is a man. And we also decide you should not, it should be 50-50, not necessarily a zebra. Because if you make it a zebra, it will mean one gender will only be deputizing. You understand? Yes. Because if you have a man, the president, the vice president will be a woman. The secretary general will be a man. And then the deputy secretary general will be a woman. So we say it's 50-50, but not necessarily a zebra list. However, when it comes to others, it should be a zebra list. Because otherwise, it will not work. So that's how we are featuring in as far as women empowerment is concerned. However, colleagues, we still believe that there's still much to be done. We have not yet reached a fully gender equality